gracious Father in heaven, we're grateful for the beautiful day that you've given to us. We're grateful for the way that you have brought Aimee's path and Michael's path together. We believe that it is your will and your plan for them to be joined together in marriage today.
This is love, it lives. Heaven knows it's high.
It takes a man with great wisdom and understanding to realize his dreams and achieve his goals.
Oh!
Yet still stay true to his ethics and morals.
Whoa! Wow! Look at that. I wonder if it's set. What time is it right now?
Three o'clock.
It's already set.
We've been talking about different aspects of relationships and different elements of marriage and how to have a successful marriage and what the Bible has to say about the key elements to a healthy and strong marriage. And I have to say that I believe that Mike and Aimee are here prepared to move on to this step in their life. I believe before you this afternoon is a wonderful couple that is mature, that is strong in their relationship with each other, is strong in their determination to do what's best, to commit themselves for the rest of their lives here in front of you this afternoon.
It takes something more this time, sweet, sweet lies are now.
Today's day one of a great life you have together, and your husband and wife today. It's day one of a great adventure, and I'm honored to share it with you as being your best man, Mike. And I wish you both peace and happiness, and may God bless your union. Cheers, you guys.
Also very excited to create their own family today. They woke up this morning as two single individuals, and they're going to leave this event this evening as a married couple and go through the journey of bringing two lives together as one. The Bible tells us that today they are leaving their father and mother, and they're cleaving to each other. And they're making a commitment this afternoon to each other as their number one priority for the rest of their life.
I've known Aimee for about 5 years, and there's three things that I've come to know about her, if not more. One, that she's very generous, and I don't know if you've all had time to read this compassion card, but I mean, she really spends a lot of time doing for others, and for obviously sponsoring those in Africa with Mike, and I think that's really sweet. And she's very passionate. She definitely means what she does for people, and she's always there for her friends, her family. She's just very passionate, and she's very generous and genuine.
It's been very inspiring to me to notice that at a young age they have solid character, that the choices that they have made and the choices that they are making and the choices I believe they're going to continue to make are choices that will emulate the character that they've been instilled in them and that they continue to develop. Because they're making some tough decisions, and they're going to continue to make those tough decisions. And so their commitment and their character to one another is going to be so strong in the days coming. It's going to work because of their character.
You're gonna make her cry. I've been able to watch the relationship develop, and it's just been wonderful to see the two of them together. And if there's anything I can share with the two of you, it's that there are three things that last in life: faith, hope, and love. And the most important of those is love. And the love that you two show each other is inspiring and beautiful. And I can't wait to watch you guys continue to grow in that.
A bedrock of faith that's going to begin today in their marriage. That they've made a commitment personally to the Lord Jesus, and they've made a commitment that He would be the foundation of their marriage. So their idea of family and character and faith are three very solid elements in the life of this young couple that you see before you today.
Dreams really do come true. Someday you wish upon a star. Wake up.
Michael, do you take Aimee to be your wife? Will you promise here and now before God and these friends to be to her a true and faithful husband? Do you promise to love her, honor her, cherish her, provide for her, and to protect her from this day forward? Are you willing to commit yourself to Aimee and her alone until death parts you? If you are willing here and now to make this promise to her, you may answer, I do.
I do.
Bluebirds fly and the dream that you did to, oh why.
And Aimee? Do you take Michael to be your husband? Will you promise here and now before God and these friends to be to him a true and faithful wife? Do you promise to love him, honor him, cherish him, respect him, and to be with him from this day forward? Are you willing to commit yourself to Michael and him alone until death parts you? If you are willing here and now to make this promise to him, you may answer, I do.
I do.
I see skies of blue and I see clouds of white and the brightness of day. I like the dark and the...
I'm Michael.
Take you, Aimee.
Take you, Aimee.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
Knowing in my heart...
Knowing in my heart...
That you will be my constant friend.
That you will be my constant friend.
My faithful partner in life.
My faithful partner in life.
To laugh with you.
To cry with you.
To cry with you.
To grow with you.
To grow with you.
In mind and spirit.
In mind and spirit.
To always be open and honest with you.
To always be open and honest with you.
And to cherish you.
And to cherish you.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
I love you. I hear babies cry and I watch them grow. They'll learn much more.
With this ring.
I confirm my promise to you.
I confirm my promise to you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
With this ring.
I confirm my promise to you.
I confirm my promise to you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And the Son.
And the Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Be where trouble melts like a lemon drops. High above the chimney top, that's where you find me, oh, somewhere.
Michael and Aimee, since you have answered these questions, shared these vows as your lifelong pledge to be married to each other, and so you've exchanged these rings as gifts to demonstrate this unending love, and by the authority vested in me as a pastor in the great state of California, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Since God has brought you together, may nothing ever separate you. Michael, you may kiss your bride.
You know, it's tough to live here in America. You have everything. But it's one thing to begin a family and you already have five that you care for, you know? Children you've never seen, children you've never visited, but somehow that you have a passion to see them grow well. And that's what I saw in Aimee and Mike, and Mike's family as well, that they've always really considered others.
I remember when she was a little girl. Now she's big and going on with life, as she should be. You know, we all grow up and we all have to make decisions. But it was a moment that from then on, I simply was going through the routine. I was remembering how my relationship with her and with my wife.
Countless levels under cover of the street. You know that I can use somebody.
Somebody. I don't know who can put up a wedding and be able to rather tell their story, but tell the story of those little unknown children that they sponsor. And to me, that is a family. That is value. That is faith.
I'm thrilled for Mike. I have not known Mike for a long time, but I have not known his parents either. But I can tell by their love for themselves, for the family, and so on, that this is a family that I can invest time with and like that and feel comfortable that they're close to what Hazel and I have. I hope it's gonna make you know that.
You know, I was a sponsored child, you know, as little picked up on the streets of Kampala. To me, I can honestly say thank you on behalf of the children in Africa, the children you sponsor. We want to say thank you and we want to wish you the best. And we know you'll be with those little ones as long as God blesses you.
So Mike, you now have my daughter, and I'm happy for you. You have a partner in life.
And we can't wait for you to tell the story to those little ones as I go to Kenya in a few weeks, just to be able to say, hey, you get a family, and it's getting bigger and bigger. And on behalf of those kids, honestly, I can't stop to say thank you. And may the Lord bless you. May He really give you, I don't know how much, but so much. Blessings. To the toast. Cheers.
To the new family. I was looking down at all I